Thank you for visiting this video segment of Dr. AFib. I'm Dr. Morales. Today we're going to be talking about beta blockers and why you are very likely prescribed a beta blocker. If you've been diagnosed with atrial fibrillation, it's very likely that at some point you were prescribed a beta blocker, which the most commonly used is metoprolol. However, there are a variety of others, including carvedilol, atenolol, labetalol, bersoprolol, just to name a few. So, why were you likely prescribed a beta blocker? Well, first, let's talk about the physiologic effects of these beta blocker medications. It works on the beta receptors throughout your body, and it can, one, lower your blood pressure, and two, slow down your heart rate. And what I tell my patients is that it basically has an anti-adrenaline effect. It actually blocks some of the stress-related hormones, particularly epinephrine and norepinephrine, and that's how it lowers your blood pressure and slows your heart rate down. But as far as atrial fibrillation goes, it has a few additional effects on it. One, it can reduce the frequency of extra beats of your heart, something called premature atrial contractions, which can help trigger episodes of atrial fibrillation. So it reduces the frequency of you potentially getting an episode of atrial fibrillation. In addition, if you're on a beta blocker medication and you're somebody whose AFib comes and goes, when you get an episode of atrial fibrillation, the heart rate will be less rapid because of the beta blocker medication. So those are some of the physiological effects of the actual medication itself. Another reason why people commonly get prescribed beta blockers, especially when they're first diagnosed with atrial fibrillation, is just familiarity. Beta blockers are used commonly in a lot of different other health conditions, including high blood pressure. It's also used for coronary artery disease, congestive heart failure. So a lot of doctors are very familiar with these medications and familiar with the dosages. In addition, beta blockers are very unlikely to have long-term side effects or cause long-term damage to any of your organs in your body, like your liver or your kidneys. So they tend to be safe long-term medications to use. And those are the variety of reasons why people end up being started on beta blockers. However, that doesn't mean that everybody can tolerate them. There are a variety of reasons why somebody would not be able to tolerate a beta blocker medication. One would be that your heart rate is just too slow. People who have AFib episodes that come and go, when you're not in atrial fibrillation, your heart rate may be very slow. It may be in the 50s or 60s to begin with. And so you would not be able to tolerate the addition of a medication like a beta blocker, which would slow your heart rate down further. Also, as I mentioned, the beta blocker medications also affect blood pressure. They have blood pressure effects. And again, there are some people who just don't have high blood pressure, and really can't tolerate the effects of the medication, that even low dosages of the beta blockers end up reducing their blood pressure too much. In addition, there are plenty of patients out there who don't really tolerate this anti-adrenaline effect that these medications can have. They just feel constantly fatigued or sleepy or dizzy or lightheaded from the medications. I've even had people describe to me that they just kind of feel like their head is in a fog a lot, or they're just walking through water, just kind of slowness of everything around them from the effects of the medications. And so even though these are good long-term medications to use, there are some people who just cannot tolerate it. Now, some of these kind of anti-adrenaline effect, this kind of foggy feeling, people can kind of get used to them and can continue taking them, but not everybody does. So in general, these medications are good long-term medications, but not everybody can tolerate them. And so if you're taking a beta blocker and you really feel that it's causing you side effects like fatigue or dizziness, please discuss these with your doctor, because there are actually many options available other than just beta blockers. Thank you for visiting this video segment of Dr. AFib. I'll see you next time.